Your life will never be the same.
Don't you know your life will turn around?
Resurrection power is here to take.
Praise the Lord, beloved. Wednesday, a great day. Make sure you go to Bible study tonight. If your church has Bible study Wednesday nights, we do Wednesday nights. Some churches have Tuesday nights, some have Thursday. It doesn't matter. Just go to church and add to the word you heard Sunday. Keep building yourself up on your most holy faith. The Bible says praying in the Holy Ghost and being strengthened by the word of God. We are studying the breastplate of righteousness, and we have reached a critical point in our study because God gave the Old Testament priest a breastplate, and on this breastplate are the 12 stones he named. Each tribe has a stone, and each stone was arranged, or the stones were arranged in rows, four to a row, three rows, representing the 12 tribes of Israel. I'm sorry. And we learn then from that mystery, I'll read it to you once again, that the heart of the priest must be right towards the people of God. This is the hardest thing for most of us to do. We are running from relationships, but yet the breastplate, if you can manage relationships, you can keep Satan out of your heart. The breastplate of righteousness is the ability to carry God's people with you into the throne room, not accusing them, but interceding for them before God. Beloved, this mystery is the reason the church is constantly under attack, because Satan makes sure that somebody does something to offend you, somebody does something to disappoint you, somebody does something to wound you, and then your breastplate falls off, or there's a hole in it. So this happens, you plug this one out, a hole exists. This one happens, you plug that one out, a hole exists. Before long, now Satan sees wide open gaps to shoot at you, because God set the people in your life in your breastplate. Wow, have you ever heard this teaching before? Beloved, this is what is missing. Don't view the breastplate as a defensive weapon. As I said, it is really a powerful offensive weapon, because when you are rightly positioned before God, you have power before God and power with man in Jesus' name. I told you that, but let me read it to you so you can see. Once again, verse 15 of Exodus 28. God commanded, thou shalt make the breastplate of judgment. You notice, he called it the breastplate of judgment. In the New Testament, he calls it the breastplate of righteousness, because the judgment will be determined by these relationships. That's where we rise or fall. That is why I said to you yesterday, and I'm saying again, any relationship with God that is only vertical is a pole. But Jesus died on a cross, on a tree, whatever you call it. Yes, beloved, we are called to follow his steps. This stuff is not easy. It wasn't easy for God. God many times wanted to kill the children of Israel himself. God's people are very difficult to handle. They're stubborn, they're self-willed, they're prideful, they're strident, they're independent. They're right always, they never, that's being a pastor is the hardest job I believe in this life, I'm telling you. That's why most pastors have very poor health. If you don't know how to manage this as a leader, you die prematurely. I know a pastor up the street from me that just died. You just check out. Your heart breaks because you love people. You don't know that they don't even love you. Anytime they find a little fault with you, they just drop you. Your heart is broken up. Then people cheat you or deceive you. And before long, you're bitter. And then you don't trust anybody. You don't love anybody. And then your ministry dies. What happens to leaders? That's what's happening to God's people. Friendships break up and things change and everything. It just goes on and on. It's a fight. It's a fight. But Satan knows that if we can get the breastplate together, boy, our destiny will soar. We can get it. It's the breastplate of judgment. That's where things are determined. These lateral relationships. The Bible says, how can a man say he loves God whom he has not seen and does not love his brother whom he has seen? He said, this commandment we received of him, that he who loves God should love his brother also. What do you do when your brother keeps wounding you, when your brother keeps trying you, when your brother keeps on and they never stop? Oh, beloved, we have to run for refuge in the love of God to keep our hearts protected from demonic attacks. And if we fail at this, we fail at everything. That's why it's called the breastplate of judgment. If you, as a priest, cannot carry the people into the presence of God, your ministry will fail. Wow, beloved, I pray that it will instruct you to wisdom, it will help you to learn, that your destiny will be determined by these relationships and what goes on in them. He says, if you don't forgive, they won't forgive you. If you don't forgive, you won't come out until you pay the last farthing. He says, tormentors will be in your life. You can get around these things. Stop trying to relate to God and then diss people and ignore people and cut off from people. It will not work. May the Lord give you wisdom. We love you. We'll see you tomorrow. Make sure you go to church tonight. Pastor Chief, and bye-bye.
The Lord is waiting on you. The Lord is waiting on you.
Yes, he is, yes, he is, yes, he is, yes, he is.